Distinguished guests, graduands, your families and your friends, bond colleagues, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to this morning's ceremony for the conferring of degrees in the Faculty of Business and the Faculty of Health Sciences and Medicine. It gives me great pleasure to introduce Bond University's Chancellor, Dr. Helen Nugent, AO.
Graduands, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me enormous pleasure to welcome you to this morning's graduation ceremony. I acknowledge the traditional owners of the land on which we meet, and I pay my respect to their elders, both past and present. What a great day this is for each of the graduands sitting in this hall. As I look out, I see each of you with a justified sense of achievement, satisfaction, and dare I say a little excitement on completing your studies. I also see pride on the faces of all of the families, the supporters, and the friends who are here with you today to support you as you mark this really important milestone in your life. You are part of a small yet growing cohort of Bondies. We at Bond are very proud of our uniqueness as an Australian university. We are small, but we punch above our weight, and we're proud of that. We make no apologies for it. And we are also overwhelmingly focused on the quality of your experience. It's easy for me to say that, but let me give you some facts. In the 2016 Good Universities Guide, Bond achieved 5-star ratings, the highest possible, for its teaching quality, delivery of generic skills, the staff-student ratio, and the overall satisfaction of its students. In addition, we get consistently high ratings for starting salaries and getting a full-time job. The globalisation of our programs also ensure that our graduates are well placed to pursue the careers that you desire, often on a world stage. By way of example, recent alumni events in North America brought together alumni spanning 3 decades of Bond education to relive their Bond experience and to forge new alliances as well. Further events will shortly be held in Tokyo and London. Bond truly spans the globe. Our unique atmosphere contributes to the continued success of our students and researchers. In the School of Health and Sciences, Associate Professor Justin Keogh has just been awarded a major grant from the Department of Social Sciences for a research program designed to help the aging population stay independent for a longer period of time. The program looks at practical applications available to the aging population in a real-world setting. It is well recognised that exercise is a fantastic option for offsetting age-related challenges that each of us in turn face, regrettably some sooner than others. Improved health and mobility also has social benefits, which in turn improve mental health. All of these factors contribute to the advantages of being physically active in older age. Also in the School of Health and Sciences, a team of 9 Bondies will be conducting research into prostate and bladder issues. This research will be undertaken in collaboration with our research partners, the John Flynn Hospital and Genesis Care in Southport. This project allows our doctoral, master's and honours students to participate in real-world research with a practical application. The Faculty of Business has launched new Masters of Actuarial Science and a Master of Actuarial Practice program. The program focuses on business acumen. Students are encouraged to look at the real-life applications and the impact of their discipline on a company or industry. Bond is the first Queensland university and only one of a few nationally that has received accreditation from the Actuaries Institute, enabling it to deliver actuarial science degrees. On my own behalf and on behalf of the Council of the University and all staff, I wish you every success when you take up your chosen careers. Congratulations on your graduation this morning, and stay in touch with this great institution of ours. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm now absolutely delighted to introduce this morning's guest speaker, Ms. Maxine Brenner. Ms. Brenner has extensive experience in Australian corporate life. The list of her corporate and professional achievements is truly impressive. Ms. Brenner is a leading Australian non-executive company director with a broad experience with a number of major Australian corporates. She is a non-executive director of Orica Limited, Qantas Airways, Growthport Properties, and Origin Energy. She gives back to the community as a director of the State Library of New South Wales Foundation. She is also a member of the advisory panel of the Centre for Social Impact at the University of New South Wales, and she is also a member of council at the University of New South Wales. None of us will hold that against her. So, and she most definitely has a very keen interest in education. Maxine holds the degrees of Bachelor of Law and Bachelor of Arts from the University of New South Wales. So you can see that career transitions are very possible. Her broad corporate experience across a number of industry sectors, including media, telecommunications, property, transport infrastructure, and the public sector, has led to her being a sought-after advisor in all aspects of corporate advisory, acquisitions, and restructuring. She has also worked at a national law firm specialising in all aspects of corporate law. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Ms. Maxine Brenner.
Thank you for your generous introduction, Chancellor. Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, members of faculty, parents and friends, and most important of us all, graduands. It's a real honour for me to be invited to speak to you today. You've achieved great success. You should feel very proud. My warmest congratulations to you and those who are with you today who've supported you through your journey. I recently came across a memo about a schoolgirl who didn't do quite so well. She was not going to graduate like you all. From the science master, subject failure. Dear headmistress, student X should be disciplined severely. Key data points are as follows. 26 instances, no ribbon in hair. 13 instances, wrong colour of ribbon in hair on days she was wearing a ribbon. 2 instances, dancing in the science lab, humming while doing experiments, leading to removal from classroom to attend reflection time in the corridor. 1 instance removed from class for the rest of this term for failing to do homework. In all, 42 infractions over a 6-month period, punishment recommended, suspension or expulsion. Failure. It comes in all shapes and sizes, and for this 15-year-old girl, she felt it as an epic fail. I did some research about graduation speeches, and it seems over the last few years, it has become quite the fashion to talk about the joys of failure. In a graduation speech to Harvard, Oprah Winfrey challenged by saying, "Do the one thing you think you cannot do. Fail at it. Try again. Do better the second time. The only people who never tumble are those who never mount the high wire." And J.K. Rowling, "It's impossible to live without failing at something, unless you live so cautiously that you might as well have not lived at all, in which case you failed by default. And you've probably heard Steve Jobs, if we want to be great, we've got to risk failure. So failure is the new black, and we come away from these conversations feeling energized, courageous, and ready to take on the world. And these are really important messages, and ones that need to be told and told again, if we are to reframe how we approach failure. But there's always been something niggling at the back of my mind about these conversations, something that's missing from these speeches about failure. When I was thinking about these failure conversations, it occurred to me that it's really easy to engage when you're hearing about someone else's failure. And someone else's failure never poses quite the same challenges as our own. And mostly, we only hear their failures at the end of their highly successful careers. When we are dealing with failure, we're in the midst of failing. We do not have the privilege of looking back, nor seeing it through that prism of success. So the failure wisdom does not help us with our feelings when we fail, and these are the feelings that so often shame and paralyze and prevent us from trying again. So I was asking myself, how do we change this? Perhaps it's through asking a different question. Rather than asking how we do a better job at embracing failure, perhaps we should also be asking how we do a better job of learning from failure. I recently heard about a successful Canadian engineer who joined Engineers Without Borders to bring pumped water to schools in India. He spent a year of his life and considerable donors' funds building a highly effective pumped water system. His achievements were widely acclaimed, both in India and on his return in Canada. Some 12 months later, he was told the system had failed. He went back to India to discover that every pump was clogged due to a lack of maintenance. What was even more disturbing was the discovery that in the past 10 years, three earlier pump systems installed by three different organizations had also failed for exactly the same reason. The same mistake had been perpetuated four times because no one had had the courage to speak of and share their failures. He decided to go back to Canada and write a failure report, an annual report that would document the failures of these projects. It was designed to give a platform for others in the engineering community who were not in India to come together annually, to hear about the failures, to understand in a granular way what went wrong, and then to collaborate around how the problems could be solved. Instead of consigning both person and idea to the failure bin, the wider engineering community was given the opportunity, not only to learn from the mistakes of others, but also the opportunity to build on those failures. So sharing and collaborating around failure go a long way in helping us to understand and leverage it. But there's something more. The missing piece in this discussion is bigger than that. It's about compassion, putting yourself into the shoes of others, inverting the picture so that we feel the learning rather than just hear it. When we collaborate with compassion, something different happens. We start to feel the process and understand the steps. We have empathy for the dilemmas, and we engage in why they chose to make the decision or follow the paths they did. We internalize the learnings. Those of us who are best at that are in the best position to learn. And in doing so, the learning will not only help us avoid these mistakes, but help reframe our own attitudes to building success out of failure. There's another element to this compassion discussion, which is perhaps even more important for me. If we are compassionate, not only in the way we think about another's failure, but in the way we deal with the person who has failed, it empowers them to move forward. It gives them courage to push the reset button and see their attempt as Thomas Edison did when he said, "I've not failed. I've just found 10,000 ways that won't work." For him, failure was not a destination. It was a waypoint on the road to success. So how did the headmistress respond to the science master's memo? She called the tearful girl into her office and asked her to sit. She talked to her for over an hour. What was the girl curious about? What was important to her? What did she think failure was? How did she imagine success? And at the end, the headmistress rose and said, clearly, there is a problem, but I'd like to think there's a solution. Instead of the class you've been disrupting, you will come to my office each week for an hour. In advance of that hour, you will prepare something to discuss with me, something that excites you, something you are passionate about, and we will talk. And the preparation must be done to the best of your ability. And I have faith that it will be, because I have faith in you, Maxine. That was all it took. That year was one of my best years at school, and yes, after that I wore the right coloured ribbons and tried not to get sent out of class. She took time to understand my frustrations and why I was being disruptive. And most of all, she used her compassion not only to understand, but to do so in a way that helped another person change direction and be the best they could. And this is my message to you. I have faith in the education that you've been so privileged to receive at Bond. I have faith in your curiosity and your capacity to learn. I have faith that you will seize the challenges of your chosen profession and seek to create and innovate and make a difference. And in a time of great uncertainty and change, you will understand the privilege of your position and your intellect. Try the things that are too hard to try, learn from the failure of others, use those learnings to push through your own missteps. Collaborate to reset, reimagine, and ensure others are learning alongside you. And most of all, understand that compassion will not only transform your journey, but the journeys of those travelling with you. And the success you'll feel in helping another will count as some of your greatest success. Fail, collaborate, be compassionate, repeat. Congratulations and my very best wishes.
Maxine, I, at various stages, have also done my research on what makes a wonderful graduation address. Typically, what you find is that graduation speeches are forgotten. Not only are the meanings forgotten, but the person who gave them is often forgotten. I can assure you, in this particular instance, none of the graduates sitting in this hall today will forget such an inspirational speech, such a personal speech, such a speech that I think inspires us to greater heights, to learn from failure, to set yourself up for success, and to do so with great compassion. I count Maxine as a friend, a wonderful friend, a professional colleague. I can absolutely assure you that what she's spoken of to you today is exemplified every day in her life. She supports others and she helps them, including myself, learn from their failures. She is a wonderful person, a great professional, and someone who I know you will never forget her graduation address. Can you join me again, ladies and gentlemen, in thanking Maxine?
I'll now ask all the candidates for degrees to please stand. Chancellor, I wish to present the following graduands who are in attendance today for admission to awards of Bond University. From the Faculty of Business, 96 graduands. From the Faculty of Health Sciences and Medicine, 10 graduands. Now, I certify to you and to the University Council that the graduands have satisfied the requirements for admission to the award for which they are being presented today.
With the authority of Council, I hereby admit you to the awards for which you have qualified. I also admit to their awards those candidates listed in the graduation program who are unable to be with us today.
Ladies and gentlemen, that was the formal moment of their graduation. Please congratulate them. We will now move to the presentation of the individual awards. Will the graduates please be seated?
Chancellor, the following graduates are presented for the award of research doctorates. For the degree of Doctor of Philosophy, from the Faculty of Business, with the thesis title Financial Statement Fraud Detection Using Supervised Learning Methods, I present Adrian Charles Benjamin Gepp. From the Faculty of Health Sciences and Medicine, with the thesis title Cytotoxic Drugs and Their Effects on Bladder Function, I present Sung Hyung Kang. From Health Sciences and Medicine, with the thesis title Cyclophosphamide and Iphosphamide, Mechanisms for Cytotoxic Action and Consequences for Normal Bladder Function, I present Kylie Alexandra Mills.
I now invite the Acting Executive Dean of the Faculty of Business to join me in congratulating each of his graduates as they are presented.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Faculty of Business. For the degree of Bachelor of Business, Shivan Akshay Arora. Natasha Bernadette Chand. Yingchun Chen. Basha Alid. Jean Etwiler. Jared Wade Jeffrey. Georgia Hope Kelleher. Christina LaParden. Leda Lee. Andre Malmberg. Akash Pramod Moore. Cassandra Riley. Lutfia Suchi Permatasari. Dominic Ralph Sig. Fideli Svensson. Tiffany West. Zheng Li Da. For the Bachelor of Business and Bachelor of International Hotel and Resort Management, Lauren Raven. For the Bachelor of Commerce, Maria Cecilia Helena Bassa. Rebecca Eloise Bruff. Matthew Mark Howell. Dylan Master. Kelly Deanne MacDonald. Mushia Gloria Mutombo. Kirk Reynoldson. Nicola Severin Chop. Mojo. Bachelor of Business and Bachelor of Commerce, Gina Catalina Ellis. Chantel Louise Jackson. Dear Bianca Di Lau. for the Bachelor of International Hotel and Tourism Management, Thepret Chawla. Paige Hudson. Andrea Caden. Jasmine Natalie Lisciotto. Brianna Claire Lurs. Courtney Elizabeth Miller. Zhang Yilun. Zhang Yiren. For the Postgraduate Diploma of Business, Stephen James Seman. For the Master of Accounting, Megan Patricia Dilling. Benjamin Doran. Leo Guochang. Ryan Wharton. For the Master of Accounting and Master of Business Administration, Geishan Senanayake. For the Master of Accounting with High Distinction and Master of Business Administration, Venice Burkett. For the Master of Accounting Professional, Mohammed Aliuddin Ahmed. Yin Junju. For the Master of Business Professional, Rashiket Varma. For the Master of Business Administration, James Andrew Candler. Chir Bao Jin. Sarah Comey. Sina Abadi. Rachel Hanna. Ali Khan. Vanessa Lee. Stacey Lynn Nichols. Yeah. Chris Orman. Brett Richardson. Molly Marie Welderly Sorrell. Christina Teravanish. Vignesh Menon Venugopal. Liang Hui Wan. Paul Brandon Wincop. For the Master of Business Administration, Corporate, Rami Antar. Cameo Faith Ash. Andrew James Bain. Jody Louise Freestone. Leslie Ann Gregg. Vipul Kumar Patel. Malcolm Leonard Perry. Kerry Siggs. Brendan James Stewart. Dean Jeffrey Williams. For the Master of Business Administration, Corporate, with high distinction, Glenda Abraham. For the Master of Business Administration, Professional, Yiwen Shen. For the Master of Finance Professional, Som Ranga.
The university is very proud of its long association with Business Breakthrough Incorporated in Japan. Together, we teach a Master of Business Administration program tailored to meet the needs of Japanese business. I now invite Dr. Kenichi Omai, the Managing Director of Business Breakthrough Incorporated, to present graduates from the Bond University BBT Global Leadership MBA.
Chancellor, I wish to present the following 27 graduates in the Bond University BBT Global Leadership MBA. 12 of the 27 are attending. They have flown into Gold Coast over the last couple of days and are attending this ceremony. Sadanori Abe. Yoshie Goto. Yasuhiko Hayashi. Hiroshi Hirasawa. Kumiko Kasai. Kiichi Kinouchi. Yoko Kitauchi. Nahoko Sato. Tomokazu Taguchi. Kaori Takahashi. Shigeki Yamashita. Kou Yatabe. Another 15 have not been able to attend this ceremony, but they will watch this ceremony through satellite television in Japan. Let me read these names. Yasuaki Hidaka. Koji Ichiba. Daisuke Kashiwabara. Tomohiko Kubota. Yukiko Mita. Akinori Murata. Tomoyuki Nakamura. Tomoyuki Odagiri. Takanori Ookuwa. Hironori Sakano. Toshihiro Sato. Akimi Sugihara. Katsuichi Tachibana. Takamitsu Takiguchi. Ryuta Yamazaki.
I now invite the Executive Dean of the Faculty of Health Sciences and Medicine to join me in congratulating each of her graduates as they are presented.
Chancellor, I present graduates from the Faculty of Health Sciences and Medicine for the degree of Bachelor of Biomedical Science, Kang Dao. Sherilyn Noel Herbert. Ambalika Luxton. For the Bachelor of Exercise and Sports Science, Exercise Science, Anna Louise Thorley. for the Bachelor of Health Sciences, Shubitha Ignatius. Amy Marie Stroud. For the Bachelor of Sports Management, Rhett James Parker. Chancellor, the graduate selected to give the valedictory address on behalf of all those graduating today is graduating with the degree of Bachelor of Business. I present the valedictorian, Chelsea Lee Alexander.
Good morning, Chancellor, Vice-Chancellor, distinguished guests, honoured academic faculty, proud families, friends, and most importantly, my fellow graduates. Congratulations, we really did it. I cannot express how honoured I am to be able to address you here today at our graduation. Graduation is one of those awkward days. Awkward because we're excited and proud of ourselves, but are also sad to say goodbye to this chapter in our lives. Personally, deciding that Bond University was the next chapter in my life was a very easy decision. My father was the first undergraduate student ever to graduate from Bond, and it was his stories and his passion for this uni which brought me here. I can still remember him explaining to me this silly story of him and his friends putting a Batman poster in what used to be just the cold and dark computer labs under the library. Yes, Dad, almost 100 semesters later, it is still known as the Bat Labs. Being a Bond University cheerleader, I now have embedded in my mind our slogans like come together, go beyond. However, I was soon to realise that these are not just strategic marketing tactics, but it is actually the way of life here. Bond creates such a strong community of different individuals from all over the world, a sense of community which coexists with individual purpose. Bringing ambition to life is truly the most perfect way to sum up our experience, and this is something I don't think will ever change. Ambition is found amongst these sandstone walls. What Bond University means to me is different from what it means to my family or to what it means to each of you. For instance, my mum and dad thinks it is the place that made me stress to unbelievable levels. And my brother thinks it is the place that made me drunk to unbelievable levels. Bond means many things to me, but mostly it is a place full of memories. From tripping down the thinking steps in week one, to achieving my first Vice-Chancellor Award in semester two, to losing my passport in Los Angeles whilst representing Bond in a world's cheerleading competition, to meeting my boyfriend at White House, to spending sleepless nights in the silent zone, to trying to understand the purpose of having both eStudent and iLearn, to attending Bondstock Splendor in the Sports Hall, and to ending my degree with my best friends by spraying watermelon passion pop under the arch. Of course, our memories at Bond are as diverse as we are. Each of you would have your own stories and emotions to remember Bond by. However, Bond has been a place we could all call home. Yes, it has given us all a world-class tertiary education in about 2 years' time. But most importantly, it has given us a global network of people we now have for the rest of our lives. Not just academically or out in the workforce, but stronger friendships than we could have ever imagined. I can trust all of you also look back with great appreciation of your time here at this university. Bond changes us. We truly do become Bondies. Being a Bondi means we now appreciate our mother's cooking more than ever. It means we are leaders. It means we are hardworking. It means we can no longer drink vodka or Red Bull, let alone them together. It means we are knowledgeable, and it means we are a family. Although this is the end of our bond journey, I don't believe it is. We are now bondies for life. I would like to take this opportunity to thank, on behalf of the graduating semester, the people who have made our journeys possible. Firstly, thank you to the faculty members who have shared their time, talent, and knowledge with us. And thank you for always seeing our potential and pushing us to our limits. I'm sure we've all had outstanding lecturers and tutors throughout the way. I definitely have. Thanks, Raffi, for making us laugh every class. And thank you, Anthony Erickson, for always answering my emails, even when I was no longer a student of yours. It is one thing to study at such a beautiful campus, but to have academics which truly care is something else. Thank you to the student associations such as BUSA and the BSA, who made our time here filled with free food and continuous social events. I also want to thank our friends and family who have supported us ever since day one. You demanded excellence from us whether or not we wanted to give it. We would not all be here today without your patience, love, and motivation. So thank you. Standing up here today, talking to a group of such talented individuals, I now realise that graduation shouldn't be an awkward day. It should be a day where we celebrate together and not think that today is the ending, but rather the beginning. As Dr. Seuss once said, "Don't cry because it's over. Smile because it happened." Graduating semester of 152. Let's make the most of every opportunity. These pieces of paper we now own open us to a world of vast opportunities, but it is us which must grab them. We need to have the dedication, the passion, and the drive to chase after what we want. And it is this graduation ceremony which has already shown us just how capable we are of accomplishing our goals when we commit ourselves to them. To quote Dr. Seuss again, "The more you read, the more you know. The more you learn, the more places you'll go." So let's leave this sports hall one last time, remembering to never stop learning. Learning from your failures, learning from your parents, and learning from each other. Thank you.
Well done, Chelsea. That was fantastic.
Chelsea, you have defined for us today what it means to be a Bondi with your personal story, your personal journey. We have smiled with you, to quote Dr. Seuss, smile because it happened. But we have also been so grateful for all you have done and all you have contributed to the university. You have heard that Chelsea graduated this morning with a Bachelor of Business degree, but what you haven't quite heard is how she graduated with that degree. She achieved, during her degree, 17 high distinctions, 7 distinctions, as well as being placed on the Vice-Chancellor's list for academic excellence over 4 semesters and the Dean's List for Academic Excellence in 1 semester. This is simply an outstanding record. And to achieve that, amongst being stressed, according to her parents, drunk, well, we never mention that, tripping down the thinking steps, but showing dedication and drive and what it means to go beyond. You are a Bondi of whom we are truly proud. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me once again in thanking Chelsea. Ladies and gentlemen, I now call upon the Vice-Chancellor and President to read the Bond University Charge to the graduates.
Will the most recent graduates of Bond University please stand? Graduates, I charge you to demonstrate at all times the highest moral and ethical standards, to apply and to continue to extend your learning to the benefit of society, to strive through your actions to promote the universal worth of all people, to pursue the highest standards in all of your endeavours, so that in fulfilling your personal goals and human responsibilities, you add to the standing of your university, and to support and uphold your university and its alumni through engagement with the Bond Alumni Organisation and through your own personal commitment. Graduates, do you accept that charge?
Yeah.
What do you reckon? I reckon that was pretty weak. So take two, all right? Graduates, do you accept that charge?
Yes.
Thank you. You may now be seated. Ladies and gentlemen, we're in the home straight and we're shortly to close formalities for this morning's graduation. Before I do that, can I thank all of those who have travelled considerable distances to be with us today, and particularly our friends and latest graduates from Tokyo. As our valedictorian spoke so passionately earlier on, there are a number of people in this audience today, and many who could not be here, who have been part of the journey of our latest graduating class. And they are family, in some cases spouses, children, almost certainly parents, grandparents, wider family, network of friends, in some cases for our postgraduate students, their employers, the wider community, and indeed, several of our benefactors who have provided financial support for scholarships to enable some of our students to complete their studies. I thank all of you for that on behalf of our graduates. But I offer the opportunity to our graduates to turn to your loved ones in the audience, give them a bit of a wave, and give them almighty cheer. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for your efforts. We recognise that the journey that our graduates have been on has been an individual journey. Each of you have your own stories. In some cases, you have worked incredibly hard under difficulties to get here today. For several of you, it has not been just the Bond Accelerated Program. It has taken many years. I'm proud of each of you and your efforts. And I trust this university has allowed you a little time to be in the limelight, just as our presentation today allows all of us to celebrate your individual achievements and your individuality. It's been a great pleasure to get to know some of you personally and more widely to be part of this great institution. I trust that we have educated you well, not just in a technical sense, but in a sense where you now understand the need to make moral decisions. When confronted with challenges over your future careers, you are now equipped to make the right decision. Your behaviours, your attitudes, the standards that you now set in life will not just reflect upon you and your family, they will now reflect upon this university. And despite the grandeur of our buildings and our landscape and our magnificent architecture, and despite the academic excellence of our faculty, and despite the absolute continued drive to support you from our professional staff, the reality is that this university and its reputation is built on the reputation of our students and our graduates. So as you now move into an alumni of this university, which numbers around 25,000 Bond alumnus spread throughout the world, grasp the opportunity to make a difference. Do not let a great education be wasted. Education is such a valuable gift that I believe that a wasted education is one of the great crimes of humanity. So you have been equipped to tackle the challenges that will confront you. Some of those challenges will not be easy. But rest assured that just as we have been part of your journey over the last few years, we will continue to be part of your journey throughout life. May I wish you all the very best in your futures and future endeavours. You will always be welcome back here. And as I think everyone knows, each May we hold a homecoming week. Please endeavour to come back, if not every year, certainly every occasional year. Join the network, catch up with your friends, catch up with your faculty, many of which you have gotten to know personally. On behalf of the university, congratulations. And ladies and gentlemen, we're inside what normally is a basketball stadium, which transforms overnight, because we are a very adaptable organisation, into a ceremonial hall. And I ask at the end of each graduation ceremony, for those in the audience who really want to let off a bit of steam, or perhaps a hooter or two, now is an opportunity to try and raise the roof. Let's congratulate the class of 152.